Now, if you have seen my previous video, I have discussed about the terms related to the laws of terms related to the reflection. Incident ray, reflected ray, normal, angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and point of incidence. Those six terms I have discussed with you. So, after this, I have to discuss with you with this diagram. You can see in the last video also I have drawn this exact diagram, the angle of incidence, angle of reflection, INR, incident ray AO, reflected ray OB. Okay, AO, incident ray, OB, reflected ray. Anyways, with this thing, I have to know one law. There is one law. A law is certain guidelines which controls this whole reflection thing. So with this, I have to know a law which is called as law of, or I'll say laws of reflection. Laws of reflection. There are two laws. So one, I will do the laws one by one so you can understand it more clearer way. The first law. What it says? The first law is very simple. It says angle of incidence should be always equal to angle of reflection. So this I have represented in an equation form. So the law says the angle of incidence means this I should be always equal to this R. So if I is 30 degree, suppose this angle is I is 30 degree, then correspondingly my R will also become 30 degree. If say I is 45 degree, then correspondingly R will also become 45 degree. So I and R are correspondingly related to one another. Okay. So if whatever the value of I, that has to be the value of R. Or in other words, you can say whatever is the value of R, that has to be the value of I. So I can say the first law states what? Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Clear? So I hope this law is clear to you, clear like crystal to you. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Now we will discuss about the second law. Now over here I will deal with the second law of reflection. The second law of reflection. The second law of reflection states that my incident ray. So I can say the incident ray. Which is the incident ray over here? AO is the incident ray. So AO is the incident ray. My incident ray, my reflected ray, okay, reflected ray, and the normal, means all the three, the normal. My incident ray, my reflected ray, and the normal, all of them lie on a same plane. Incident ray, reflected ray, and normal, all lie on the same plane. So same plane means what? Suppose I have a copy. Suppose I take this copy as the plane. So my incident ray lies over here. My reflected ray also starts from over here and normal also starts from over here. So all lie on the same surface, on the same plane. It is not like that the incident ray is over here. The normal starts from a different layer, surface, and the reflected ray from a different surface. No, it is not like that. All of them lies on the same surface. So on the same surface means what? On the same plane. The incident ray AO, my reflected ray OB, and the normal OA lies on the same plane. But if you see, a plane is a big surface. Say this board is also a plane, which is a very big surface. But exact where it lies, where on the surface, okay. But exact where it lies on the same plane, at where? At the this O point. So O is what? Point of incidence. At the point of incidence. So all the three ray lie on the same plane, same surface, but surface is a very big surface. Like a field is also a surface. It's a, like with the field that you play football is also a surface, a very big surface. Now I am saying all the three rays lies on that field, but exactly where on the field, because field is a very big. So you'd say that at that point where near the tree, when you say, so on the field, I am mentioning a particular position like that. This surface is a very big surface, but where exactly on the surface? At the point O. So all of them lies at the point O, and this point O is called as what? Point of incidence. So all of them lie on the same plane. Where? At the point of incidence. So it is very important you mention this, at the point of incidence. So this is the second law of reflection. So I hope by this fourth video, I hope this concept of reflection, it to a certain extent, is clear to you. Comment section is open. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. I will answer them. So in the next topic, we will discuss about how our image is formed by a plane mirror. So we will discuss about those things in the upcoming videos. Till then, take care. Bye. Good night.